The name of it is Nyckelharpa. Can you say Nyckelharpa?
No.
Yeah, good. Nyckelharpa. Nyckel means key. So it's, if you literally translate it, it's a keyed harp. It's more like a keyed fiddle, but the name is Nyckelharpa. So all these wooden keys here, they stop the string from the side. This small peg sticking up on each key, stopping the string from the side, giving a higher pitch. It's like bringing a fret to a string instead of pressing the string to a fret. And then I play with this short little bow on a few strings. On this old one, this is the style of the 1700s, a drone instrument, so I only play melody and drone on this one. It's only three strings I reach with the bow. The rest of the strings are cut down in the bridge. So they're called sympathetic strings. They sympathize with the notes being played by the bow. It's a little hole here, a sound hole here as well.
Wow.
And according to old fiddlers or old nyckelharpists, you should hang the nyckelharpa like this on the wall, so it looks like this face. If you hang it upside down, the sound will pour out and it will die. Oh, sad, isn't it? And if you look on old nyckelharpas, on this little, it's a little heart-shaped hole here under the playing mechanism, and on the kind of edge there, they tied a magic bag, and that contained, well, if you look at it, if you look in those old bags, it's mostly dust, but I don't think that's what they put in them. I've read it was dried fish heads and finger bones from good guitarists, for example.
Really?
And that kept you healthy. Prevented colds and pneumonia and stuff like that. Yeah. It's really good. And this instrument has been played for about 700 years in Sweden. The oldest proof of one is a small nyckelharpist in stone attached to a church on the island of Gotland in the Baltic Sea, and he's been sitting there playing for 700 years. So before that we don't know, but after him there's been instruments around being played.
They come in different styles also, in different time layers. This is slightly older than the other one, which is a chromatic nyckelharpa. This is not, this is oberchromatic actually. It has some blue keys to it. Can hear it. So it almost died out. Questions about the instrument? We have them on our 50 kronor bills too. We treasure them high in Sweden. We can send one around maybe, if we have one. No, we only have dollars now. Sorry. Don't be sorry. We're happy. A 50 kronor bill?
You mean a nyckelharpa?
Right.
On eBay, for example? The easiest way is probably to go to the Swedish version of eBay. It's called Blocket.se. You should know some Swedish, though.
Or you can guess.
Yeah, you can look at the pictures and just click along. And
that's what we do.
No, but if anyone is interested in knowing more about the instrument, I recommend the American Nyckelharpa Association website. It's called ANA. They have tons of information, and there's instruments sold here in the US regularly as well. People are kind of up trading to better quality. Here in this band, Roger is not really a guitarist, he's a bass player and a guitar player. He has changed his way of thinking.
I expanded my mind.
Yes.
Well, I don't know about that, but I tune my guitar slightly differently than the most common tuning. So, are you interested?
Sure.
No, you don't always say that. Well, we started to play the guitar like 50 years ago. This guitar has a tuning. I strung it up differently from a normal guitar, normal 12-string guitar, and I use the open tuning is a D from the treble side is a D-A-D-A-D-A tuning. So it's a, and that takes some restringing of the instrument.
Da da da.
Da 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 is.
Yeah.
And the low bass is a nylon bass string that goes down to contra A, so it's pretty. It saves us from carrying around a bass player. No, isn't that what you do?
Can you play something and let us hear what it sounds like?
Well, now I have a capo on the fifth fret, but this is like a drop D, ordinary drop D. So it goes down to A on the 0 fret. So I have a little, my second job is to be a bass player in a cover band. They don't know that. Yes. So, enough about the tools. Are we moving in more to the purpose? In using them. We can play another tune. Would you like that? Should we do a typical bass tune?